high, aren't they? You want a watermelon? I'm gonna get you a watermelon, dude. You want a watermelon? You want a watermelon? What are you looking for? You want a watermelon? He's doing much better today. Hi from Oregon. How you doing? He's doing much... Hi, Arthur. He's doing much better today. He was his old self this morning. Very excited about that. Hi, Alyssa. He's doing much better. Very, like I said, I was very scared. Right, man? I came out here at 4:30. Gave him some water, some orange juice. Apple juice. You want me to get you a watermelon, buddy? We're going to get him a watermelon. How's everybody doing? It's been a beautiful day. I know people are telling me that they're getting crazy weather places, but here has been absolutely gorgeous. It seems to like dabble in the rain a little, but it's been a really nice day, as you can see. We have an amazing volunteer day tomorrow. We're excited. I think we have close to 20 people signed up to volunteer tomorrow to work on the woods, pick up some rocks. We're going to get the mats ready. Hi, Allie. We're going to get the mats ready for the Stevens Way addition. So we have some mats that are had to be used other places. So we're going to scrub them down, get them ready to go in the Stevens Way barn. And then we're going to have to, we're not going to do tomorrow. I know we're going to get, he's been getting a lot. We're going to do some watermelon right now. There's Billy. I'm pretty sure Admin Inn has a pretty big live tonight with their new little baby. And this little nugget right here, like this little girl here, we're going to stop for a pit stop. She's in heat right now. She's in heat. And look at this little face. Look at this little punum. Look at that little punum. She's like, I'm so sad. So we're going to... Oh, I'm sorry. I went. Wait, hold on. Here she is. She's the good girl. She's in heat, so she's super noisy. Hold on. There you go. Hi, baby girl. Listen to this little voice. She found her voice. Come here, baby girl. Come here, baby girl. Hi. Hi. She's gonna, like, this girl is relentless. I'm not touching you. Don't you lay down. Stay up. I'm not gonna touch you because you're gonna fall down. I know you're gonna go. You're a very good girl. Don't. What are you doing? What the frick? Seriously. What are you doing? We're just trying. I just want to talk to you. She can't stay on her feet. She literally just can't stay on her feet. Like, I didn't even touch her. I literally didn't even touch her. It's just, she's like the fainting goat. She just falls down. It's just freaking ridiculous. How do you know when the pigs are in heat? Do you really want to know? I mean, personality, of course, you know, but their vulva gets pretty swollen. I'm going to leave that off right now. I'm not going to show you the vulva, but like ridiculous. Like, I don't even touch her anymore and she just falls over. The problem is she goes down like a WWE wrestler. She just like a slap, you know, she goes for a body slam. So, it's pretty ridiculous. I can't see any of the comments. Oh, there's the comments on YouTube. Sorry. She is a fainting goat. She really is a fainting goat. And we spent a lot of time together today and it was wonderful. And just getting to know her personality, and, you know, really just in my head planning when she meets other pigs and how she's going to react and who she's going to be friends with. And I know, yes, I'm talking about you. I am. You can't get up. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Oh, there we go, big girl. There we go. That's why you're not getting spaded. I know. Are you a good girl? Are you a good girl? Is she redonkulous? Yeah, the vulva gets big. She's like so cute. Hi, YouTube. We'll spay her in the winter. This way she can be out. She has some weird tongue action. I noticed that today. Could you look at that? She's done. What are you doing? Don't do it again. I know. Hi. What are you doing? Oh, she's so freaking crazy. She just makes me laugh. She makes me laugh. Like, you make me laugh. Oh, no. There she goes. What are you doing? She's so freaking funny. She might have been slipping me the tongue. She might. Hi, Todd.
Hi.
You in a good mood today, Todd?
Yeah.
Are all the male pigs are neutered? Yes. No, she's... Will you do me a favor, sir?
Yeah.
Would you be kind enough to get me a watermelon, sir?
Yes.
Thank you. Not for her. That's too much for her. She is a big goof. She's going to just be a coonie coon and hang with the coonie coons. She's going to lose weight. We'll get her spayed. What are we going to get you spayed? We're going to get her spayed in the winter. Winter is a much easier time to get spayed. One, not that she has to go in a truck, in her trailer. She'll be in the van or the Subaru or... She's done with me. Now you can see her swole the vulva. It's freaking huge. What are you doing? She's so cute. Daisy's following Todd with the watermelon. So all females are spayed and all males are neutered. That's not for you. That's not for you. That's not for you. That weird tongue is creeping me out, honey. That's a creepy tongue. That's not for you. You can smell it. Arthur's doing great. We're going to go give him a watermelon right now. Yeah, so winter's a lot easier to spay also because, one, they're not outside as much. We don't have to worry about... We don't even really have to ISO them. Unless there's an issue with the incision, but because they're not going to go in the mud, you want to do it before it snows so that it doesn't get wet. So between that, if it's raining out or it's snowing out, we'll keep them in ISO. But besides that, they're not going to, she just laid down for my voice. They're not going to go in the mud. You don't worry about fly strike. She's definitely lost a lot of weight. She looks great. You know, they decompress, they get, Petey, she'll take advantage of him. He's in heat. Petey has to get pushed really hard for Instagram pause. They're in heat for a little less than a week. So we're going to give Arthur a watermelon. To keep him hydrated. Let's see what he likes. Yeah, it looks like we had an issue with Instagram. I'm sorry. We're back. Yeah, I don't know why it was paused. We're having issues. Sorry about that. Facebook looks like it got messed up too. Hold on. Let's see Arthur. Arthur's been eating and drinking okay today. Arthur. You want a watermelon, Arthur? You want a watermelon, Arthur? There's your watermelon. Have at it. Lucky Pig was on. I know, right, Wendy? He looks so much better. He's still a little drowsy, but he's much better. Wendy, I was just talking about your button, your cute little button pig there. What a little lover. What's her name again, Wendy, that you're talking about on live? Juicy? Oh, no, that's not the name of the pig. That would be a... Is it... It's not name of... Her name's not Juicy, is it? Molly Joe. I'm like, Juicy's kind of a stripper name. Sorry. I thought someone said her name was Juicy. I'm like, that's not okay. I was going to have to call Odd Man In Complaint Department. That was weird. Molly Joe. I thought someone said her name was Juicy. I'm like, that's terrible. Yeah, Molly Joe is pretty freaking cute. Wait, we're having some size issues here. It's weird. Wendy, we're going to have a talk if you're starting to choose stripper names for your pigs. Juicy, isn't that weird? Brad, you got to talk to Wendy. She's naming pigs after strippers now. She's calling them Juicy. Now dancing on the main stage at Odd Man Inn, Juicy. That's terrible. You're going to name the next pig Top Sheet? Everybody's jumping on Facebook. I guess I offended everybody. No Top Sheets. We're having a Top Sheet clearance sale in the Arthur's Acres store. We're getting rid of all the Top Sheets. I'm not stripper shaming. Oh, someone's saying cinnamon. So we got Juicy and Cinnamon. Oh, God. I think I should stop talking. Yeah, I'm not going to say their comments are getting pretty bad. They're pretty bad. Oh, my God. Now everybody's coming up with their best stripper names. I'm not going to say anything. Oh, wait, we're getting ready. Okay, so I got to... Thanks for that nightmare. Okay, so I think we're doing hooves right now because we were going to do hooves this morning and it got a little warm. So I'm going to kind of give you a peek into what Christina's doing. So Christina's doing, we're waiting for it to cool down. So Ren's got to have hoof trim right now. So Christina tries to do like a soft run through with them. And so the pigs go through like a... You guys can't make those comments. I'm trying to have a serious conversation here. Oh, no. You know, I'm trying to be serious here and talk about a subject. I'm vegan, Megan. So, I'm trying to... She's still down for the... She's still down. I'm trying to... Yes, glitter might be construed as one of those names. So I'm changing my Facebook name to Top Sheet. No, it's no Top Sheet. So I'm going to show you what Christina's trying to do here. I'm trying to have a serious conversation. I didn't start it at all. Juicy did. So Christina's trying to walk her through this, the lift before we do it. So it's all just good memories. It's all good. So we're practicing on the lift right now. Sorry, we're just showing you what you're doing. I'm explaining what you're doing. So she's just, it's uneventful, no stress. The door's not going to close on her. She does this with a lot of the pigs when we have downtime, which is not a lot. where she'll walk them through. Did you see Odd Man's new pig, Juicy? Someone said that it's Molly Joe, but they're going with the stripper theme there now. Instagram's paused again. So she's just casually walking her through this if she does it, and then we'll walk away because we're stressing out. So this is what. So that's what we're doing right now is, you know, Juicy Joe. No, stop. I'm trying to concentrate on informational stuff right now. I'm trying to work on information here. So we're doing the walkthrough. You guys got to stop with these names, man. That's terrible. That's terrible. So I have no idea what I was talking about. Oh, we're going to do hooves right now. And so we're doing hooves right now. So Christina's doing dry runs with Ren. Her hooves need it. Her pads need it. So it's cooling down. What time's the main stage at Odd Man? What time's they're live? It's 7 my time. Whose time is 7 o'clock at Odd Man Inn? Whose time is it? So we're doing hooves right now. So she walks her through that casually, no stress, and then we kind of close them in. So 25 minutes to Odd Man Inn. Okay, so 7 my time. Carry the 1. So yes, I have 24 minutes, but we're not even going to make that because we're going to do hooves. So this is going to turn into a quick live. Because hopefully we get Ren in the shoot. So thank you so much. Swamp popsicles. We ordered stuff to make our own swamp pop. Well, they wouldn't be swamp popsicles. Oh no, she's right. Look, she's so funny. Oh, that's so fun. The main stage at Odd Man Inn. Come here, baby girl. I know. Aunt Wendy, she's in the heat. Aunt Wendy, she's in heat, and she's got a whole weird tongue thing going. She got a weird tongue. No. Don't go down. What is that's like sharp rocks. You got to stay on your feet longer. That's how you're going to lose weight, girlfriend. I got to do your dew claws a little, honey. I know. No, I'm just not. Can you use peanut butter powder for what? I use peanut butter powder. We use straight up peanut butter. Peanut butter powder for lift? For the lift? Oh, I have a really cool story that I want to share with you. This is a good story. Oh, you ordered a Rosie shirt? Thank you so much. This is a good story. So, there's Rosie. We'll see Rosie. So, I went on Facebook Marketplace. Someone was giving a futon away. And everybody knows we get futons from Facebook Marketplace. So it was like 10 minutes away. I got there to pick up a futon. It was really nice, you know, and they're always blown away by what I tell them. I know, Petey. So, hi, Angela. So he went to pick up a futon today. Very nice person. And told him what we're using for... The futon's for, again, super nice guy. And what are you doing, buddy? He was a super nice guy. Send me a message, Tina. I'll send you my contact for the pools. So, super nice guy. Told him what we're using for. Told him what our mission is. Told him what we do. And I get home. I get in the car and I see... We got a $25 donation. So not only did we get a free futon, he made a donation because he loved what we did. When I told him what we did, he went on Facebook, he looked at what we did, he went on our website and made a donation. How freaking cool is that? Like, I mean, that's when you got to spread the message of compassion. You got to tell people what's going on. You got to tell people what you do. You got to talk to people. So he gave a $25 donation and it's like, you gave me a futon, which is great because futons are horrible torture devices for people, but pigs love them. But how cool is that? I thought that was like just the nicest thing in the world. And he sent me a message. He wants to come for a tour. Oh my God, Prim's in the pond alone. It's so freaking cute. I, you know, and that's when you tell people like every dollar counts. You know, if you could do that once a day, you know, and someone gives you $25 that you never met before, never followed you before, you know, that's how we stay, you know, doing what we do. And I just thought having a conversation with this guy, I was only supposed to be there for a couple minutes, but I stayed because we just started talking about our mission and what we do. And, you know, he really loved it. And it was so nice. It was so cool. And like I said, man, I talk to everybody, anybody that's willing to listen, I'm going to tell them about the work we do. And it was such a positive impact. And he talked about that all his friends are vegetarian and he wants to go vegetarian. And I'm like, keep my number. I'm happy to help with any conversation you want to have about going vegetarian, then vegan. And he was really excited to talk about it. So I love that, you know, hi, Pram. You know, I love that I was able to get out in public because I don't like public and have a conversation with someone. And the conversation ended so positively. And I know, lovely girl. It doesn't make me want to go into public anymore, but it was a nice conversation. And I was very excited because once you plant those seeds, those compassion seeds, you know, I'm going to help this dude, you know, go vegetarian, go vegan, and more animals' lives are saved. And we got a free futon and a $25 donation, which is huge. And I'm just so excited about it, you know. And literally every dollar counts. That's huge. And it's awesome. So that was my story of the day. And that was my feel-good story of the day. And it was awesome. So thank you. I think we're going to go. I'm going to have to go help Christina do some hooves. I thought we were waiting. We're coming up on 7 o'clock. Does anybody have any quick questions while I walk up? And Becky, you are so right. He's going to share that story. And then he's going to come here with a bunch of friends. And there, and because I said, man, you got to come anytime someone, no one leaves this place without being affected, without changing their lifestyle. You know, someone like him, and he was like, no, I want to come. And so I'm going to get him here. And when he gets here, I'm telling you, he's going to go vegan right away. There's nothing better than having them connect with the animals, you know, this way, touching, feeling, seeing them, knowing that they are individuals, right? Are you an individual? Do you love your dad so much? It's crazy. Do you love your dad? I love you too. I do. So I know. Going in public can ruin your life. I agree. So I won't tell you my ShopRite story today. So that's my feel-good moment of the day. You know, and I know, grass, you know, and that just, and then there's Ann Claire running through the pasture out there, which is so cute, but I just love it. You know, that's the kind of thing that just like, I drove away, Todd came with me to help carry the futon, and I felt so good, and it, you know, it just got me a big smile. We're going to watch from afar over here while Christina, we need, the last time we trimmed her hooves, Wendy was here, and Wendy helped us. Oh, it's not Publix. It was ShopRite. I wish it was Publix. Supposedly Publix in Florida has a mean vegan sandwich. There's getting a good reputation. Publix in Florida makes a huge, they're like famous for their subs and their vegan subs. So I the last time Ren was in the lift, Wendy helped. Right? Was it Wendy? I think it was Wendy. Yeah, I'm not kidding, Brad. I'm almost positive it was when Wendy was here last time. Unless it was Joy, but I'm pretty sure it was. And Wendy, like, basically lifted her up and put her in the lift. She just lifted her up and carried her, walked her into the lift. Wendy's a strong woman. You don't mess with Wendy. She lifted a 700-pound pickup like this. Yeah, that was the anniversary party. That's right. She doesn't get her... Oh, the birdhouses are amazing. Okay, I'm going to get going because Christina needs... we're going to do this. I'm watching from afar. I'm watching from afar so I don't bother them. So she's just walking her through the lift passively. And you don't want to close the doors on them because then they remember. Oh, that's awesome. Thank you for talking about us. That's amazing. So does anybody have any quick questions? I know this is a super short live. I'm excited. I love doing hooves. The anxiety before it is, but once you get it done, it's just, you know, they feel good. So it's a good, good feeling. A lot of good things going on tomorrow. We have an amazing volunteer day tomorrow. We have Gene and Allie for the Souls, beautiful art show, which we're really excited about. A lot of wonderful things coming up, and we're, you know, staying positive, and we're very happy about it. You know, we're excited that two people that we love so much are having an art show publicly. Volunteer day tomorrow is going to be amazing. So I'm going to go help Christina. Thank you so much for all your love and support. How often do you do hooves? As often as you need. Hey, Pat, love you too. You know, it just depends. Some pigs never need it, and some pigs need it too. I had Enanami. Oh, why did I say that? Enanami, which I'm saying it wrong, pasta, tofu, meatballs, and spinach, I think, and sauce that my mom made dinner. So Enanami pasta. Enanami pasta. Enanami. It was Enanami. Have a wonderful day. Thank you so much for all your love and support. We're going to do some hooves. Peace, love, and pigs.